Hey guys, so in this video I'm excited to talk about Tearaway, which is a game that I played because it's only for the PlayStation Vita and it's made by the creators, the game designers at Media Molecule. And I have to say that Tearaway really is a gimmick more than anything. And I mean that, like, it's a gimmick because it's a game designed for the PlayStation Vita. The entire game is a gimmick, like the premise. It's a world constructed of colored paper. And that color paper world, you know, players interact with it using the PlayStation Vita device. Every functionality of Sony's latest portable device, you know, the touchscreen, the back touchpad, the camera, the front-facing camera, the gyroscope, all the bells and whistles of the Vita must be utilized to play through Tearaway. That's really the gimmick of the game, and that's what I mean. And, you know, for any other game, calling it a gimmick, it would be an insult. But what I mean for Tearaway, it's actually, that's the magic of this game, and I mean that in the most positive way possible. And let me just say this, I think Tearaway, for its entirety, it is one magical game. There's so much magic in this game, and that's probably to be expected from the creative geniuses of Media Molecule. But even though I had such high expectations, and even with my expectations, the creativity of this game is just so captivating. I kind of liken it to really the charm I felt when I first started up Kirby's Epic Yarn. It's a Nintendo game that kind of has a similar premise in that everything in that game world is made of yarn and acts like yarn. And that's really the premise of Kirby's Epic Yarn. Tearaway does a similar thing, you know. Maybe it can be claimed that Tearaway is not original because it copied Nintendo's doing that. But I don't know, if you ask me the magic of Tearaway, it's something that's magical and novel from start to finish. While Kirby's Epic Yarn for me, the novelty wore out by the game's halfway point. And to his credit, Kirby's Epic Yarn is beautiful in its entirety, but I just felt that my interest in actually playing through the game got bogged down by a slow pace. In contrast, my interest in Tearaway never waned. And even as I grew frustrated in some of the parts, and there are frustrating parts with Tearaway, I could really not hold back my fascination. I was subconsciously drooling throughout the entire experience. There's also one really extremely unique thing about Tearaway, at least in my opinion, and you know that's because almost all other games try their best to immerse the player. You know, they try to pull the gamer towards the game, into the game. In a lot of other games, the gamer is drawn to the game world by interacting with the characters and objects of the game. Tearaway does the exact opposite, kind of, in a way. The point of the game is to have Atua is the name of the player control character. And the point of the game is to push Atua into the world of the gamer. By having the desired final destination be the world of the gamer, I mean, that's how the immersion naturally occurs in this game. I, as a player, control Atua. And I, as a gamer, am witnessing the world of Atua, who himself is watching my face peering into the game world. I'm the you that Atua has to deliver the message to. Even if that involves being catapulted into the sky, rolling past the caverns, rotating around the galactic dimension. Atua wants to be connected to the gamer as much as the gamer wants to be connected to Atua, and that just breaks the fourth wall in all the right ways. And Tearaway, throughout the experience, because apparently my face is the sun of Atua's world, it does that constantly and to the end. Well, that is, until the end. For all the game's repeated emphasis on Atua being a messenger, on Atua having to get to me to deliver this message, the message itself ultimately is not that exciting. I mean, it's a nice little closing note that makes me appreciate the awesome journey I had with the game, and it makes me feel nostalgic about the journey that I had. But a part of me wishes the message itself was actually surprising and poignant, and revealed something, you know, but it doesn't. So in this regard, Tearaway is like so many other games, where the journey, and not really the final destination, is something that should be cherished. The gimmicky nature of Tearaway can get a bit off-putting in some parts, especially because using the back touchpad and the front touchscreen can get a little uncomfortable while holding the device and controlling Atua with the analog stick at the same time. I think Media Molecule must have recognized this somewhat because the game has very lenient checkpoint system and offers a lot of leeway in some selections. But it doesn't always work out perfectly. Its obsession with the Vita camera can also be annoying, especially since the quality of the pictures are many times worse than what's actually being shown up the in-game camera. I wonder if the game is kind of mocking the whole Instagram and selfies fad, but to me it really is an odd decision choice, you know, to encourage players to take pictures with the in-game camera and offering so many cool filters to use, only for its overall quality to be so blurry and fuzzy. The last thing I want to nitpick is Atwai himself, or herself if you choose to be a female. The character design is cute and charming, sure, but it's such a detailed character already that customizing it with stickers and decorations seems to defeat the purpose. In Little Big Planet, for example, I ran across Sackboys and Sackgirls who were so uniquely different than mine. If Tearaway enabled online multiplayer, which it doesn't, and not that it needs it, I don't think such originality could be encountered with Atwa. Tearaway is like any other media molecule game in that it encourages creativity of the player. But compared to the other media molecule games, including Ragdoll Kung Fu, it really fails to foster creativity on out of the players themselves. I imagine though, if Tearaway gets a sequel, and I really hope it does, I imagine that it would be really an incredible thing for players to be able to create and share Tearaway levels just like in Little Big Planet. Man, that just gives me goosebumps imagining that, and it's a really good, magical kind of goosebumps. So that's really all I have to say about Tearaway, this amazing magical game for the PlayStation Vita, and I would have to say, like, it's the flagship game for the Vita system. If you guys have any questions or comments, leave them down below and I'll be happy to reply. So, yeah, hope you guys enjoy. Cheers.